up to the ding ding dong day.
Welcome back. I hope you guys are well. Starting off a new vlog today, and I'm really looking forward to this vlog because actually this weekend Aiden and I are going on a fun little weekend trip. If you guys have ever heard of they're called the Getaway House, I believe. They have these tiny cabins in a bunch of different states. We have done this once before, but we're doing it again it's around Austin. I think it's in Wimberley exactly, which is one of our favorite places to visit in general, but we've never actually done the tiny cabin there. We've done the Dallas one and had so much fun. I'm actually shooting some content for, I don't even know if I can say a company. It's very different for me. It's actually all about driving safety. Oh my gosh. No. I'm wearing this skirt and I just realized that I cut myself shaving and it has blood all over it, which is not ideal. So gotta change. We're doing a little road trip for the purpose of that, but also to have fun. We were originally gonna try to go to Santa Fe because that is a trip that I would love to do sometime in 2023. I've always wanted to go to Santa Fe. It's about 9 hours driving from here. And we are bringing cash with us this weekend. So we're trying to find somewhere that we could bring cash, but didn't want to pay for an Airbnb, especially with moving and all that. And so we had credit for the Getaway House just from referrals. So we're gonna do some prep for that. The weather is looking very unfortunate. I think it's gonna rain the whole time, which could be cozy. It's a very cozy kind of getaway, but the whole thing is you're supposed to, you know, make all your food by the campfire and it's gonna rain, so we'll see. We're also gonna hang out with some friends. That'll be in a different vlog, but I want to prep for that this week. It's Tuesday today. I've just been catching up on work today, but for the rest of the day I really want to try to stop by an antique shop to see if I can find some pieces that we're looking for the house, which is really exciting. If we have time, I want to do that. I do have an appointment and I'm not sure how long that's going to take, so we'll see. Need to stop by the grocery store, grab some stuff for dinner. Doing an F45 workout tonight. Man, I am so bummed I got blood all over the skirt because I love the skirt. It's so comfortable. I don't know what I'm going to wear now. I'm going to have to change. I just got to Lulabee's. This is my favorite antique store in Dallas, and I also like it because there are a couple that are right next door. Benny Jack's is another one that I really like. That one's a little bit more pricey. This one's more, you can find stuff for different prices. So we're gonna browse. I don't have a ton of time because I actually was going to the wrong location. I don't know why. I was mapping it and it was taking me to Oak Cliff, and I was like, I think it was in Oak Cliff. I always remembered it being in the design district, but I got there and realized it totally took me to the wrong location. But we made it here. I don't have a ton of time to browse, which is kind of unfortunate when you're antique shopping because you really want to look and browse, but we'll just see what they have before I head to my appointment here soon. Still really excited to see if we find anything. Sorry, this angle is the worst. I didn't find anything at any of the antique stores. I saw a couple things that I liked, but nothing that I think I'll go back and consider purchasing, but it's still fun to browse around every now and then. I did see some cute stuff, but yeah, I think we're just gonna have to do some looking at just traditional furniture shops, which is totally okay. But I'm gonna go ahead and grab some groceries for the stuff that I wanna make tonight. We don't need a ton of stuff, but I have a few things that I wanna pick up. I'm gonna do like a healthier kind of turkey pasta bake tonight. I rarely make pasta, but that just sounds so good tonight. And I think I'm gonna make it ahead of our F45 workout, because anytime we have the evening workouts, we get back at 7:30 and I am ravenous at that point and need to eat right away. And so I'm gonna try to do something ahead of time so we can just come back and eat, because that sounds good. I also have to say that I have never gotten so many compliments on a dress. Every single time I wear this dress, I have probably encountered 3 people who have been so sweet about it. My dress is from Amazon, if you're wondering, and it is super affordable, but it is so cute. I've worn this so many times. I really need to get it in some new colors too. I wanted to share a grocery haul with everything I got. It's not a ton of stuff, for the sole reason that, please take a moment for this bag of kale. This is the most giant bag of kale I've ever seen in my life. It's the only one they had. Who in their right mind would eat this much kale? Are you kidding me? And I just think it's so funny, the logo is Texas. It's like, okay, everything's bigger in Texas, even the bags of kale. I can't, I'm probably gonna have to freeze some of this for smoothies or something because we will not eat all this. I'm not that crazy about kale. I just thought that was so funny. Got some string cheese. I wanna try using this red lentil pasta for our pasta bake. So I grabbed a couple boxes of those. Cookies because life is too short. Ground meat for a couple of recipes. I picked up a root beer Olipop because I wanna try to make a root beer float. I thought that would be good. We have vanilla ice cream, so I wanna try that one night for dessert. And then I also got a Synergy kombucha. This one is the Pink Lady apple. I've never had this, but I love Pink Lady apples. And then our second bag, grab some sourdough because we're about to run out. And this has pretty good ingredients for store-bought bread, so just gonna do this right now. I got a watermelon because I've really been enjoying watermelon and I've kind of been just buying it pre-cut up, which is always so much more expensive. And it's because, how do you guys pick your watermelons? I've heard that it should have one kind of sunspot, but I know they say to check if it's hollow, but I always feel like an idiot when I'm trying to pick out a watermelon, so I'm like, but I have no idea what I'm doing. So let me know if you guys have any tips. I feel like I can never buy watermelons that are actually juicy and crisp. And then just some canned stuff for our recipe. So I'm gonna cut up this watermelon and then get started on making that dinner like I mentioned. I might throw on a movie while I cook too because I watched Titanic last night, but it was so good. I don't think I've ever actually watched the Titanic full through. I saw it when I was younger, but I just never really paid attention. I thought it was boring. It was so good. So I might find something like that to watch while I cook. Got ready for a workout. Something I've been trying to do recently is wear my hair in a ponytail because it has been one of my biggest insecurities since especially this side of my hair has thinned so much. My hairline just to me looks so weird that I feel like I never wear this side. Doesn't bother me because I have a ton of growth on this side, but this side, it just does not grow as much as it used to. And so I hate wearing my hair up, but I'm trying to do it more often just to not let it bother me so much. Wearing, of course, an Almost Friday Cuts tee. I basically do all my workouts in this top now. And then these biker shorts are from Amazon. They're actually part of a set where it has like a little short sleeve top that's super cute. They're like a ribbed material. I really like them. Back from our workout, I'm about to pop our pasta bake in the oven. It looks delicious. I'm really excited. I'm glad I already made this. I'm also gonna go ahead and put together just a little side salad too to get some greens in. Although there is kale in this, so technically it has greens in it too. It is Wednesday. I'm actually headed to a brow wax appointment. I haven't got my brows waxed since I think January was the last time that I got them done. And so they're not terrible. I do still pluck them occasionally just to kind of keep them in shape. I really don't like waxing my brows too much because I like to keep them as thick as possible. I'm headed to the Benefit Brow Bar. This is the one in Plano. It's at Legacy, and this place is crazy to me because there are so many shops. If you've ever been to Legacy, they have basically any store that you could think of. And so I'm actually going to do a little bit of shopping after. Not for me. I'm meeting up with one of my kind of like internet friends that I've known for a while through Instagram. She's headed into Dallas tomorrow, so we're gonna grab lunch. And she is pregnant right now with a boy, so I was thinking of stopping in a baby store and seeing if I can just pick out a couple of things for her. I also got my Nuuly order in the mail, and this little shrug was in it. I think it's so cute. I've always wanted to wear one of these for when I work out or something, and I definitely wanted something more casual today because I'm not really feeling the best right now. Not mentally, physically, I just don't really feel good. I'm not sick. I have been having this issue with my sleep lately. If you guys don't know, I have struggled with insomnia since I was in college. It was really bad, and back then it was more so I just couldn't fall asleep, and I have no problem with that anymore.
But for the past few weeks, I have been waking up at the same time every night and really struggling to get back into a deep sleep. Every time it happens, I just feel so much brain fog and just sluggishness throughout the day. And so I always have to fight it to get through the day. I usually take a nap on days like this too, which I plan on doing. But I've just been doing some computer work and I've not really been feeling like vlogging because I just have not felt the best. But I'm starting to feel better now.
I've also been drinking this kombucha. This one is from Synergy. It's the Pink Lady Apple. I showed this yesterday in my haul, I believe. But it is so good. It tastes just like a Pink Lady Apple. It's delicious.
I think when I get home too, I'm going to try to show you guys my Nuuly haul for this month, the items that I'm renting, because everything's really cute. So might do a little try on haul. But for now, let's get these brows nice and waxed. I think it looks so good. I always keep them super, super natural. I also got the Gimme Brow product. I love that product from Benefit because it's nice when you're just lazy and just want to add some color, but you don't want to exactly fill them in too much. So I think I put a little bit too much on the side, but I think that they look good.
Ignore the fact that my makeup is all kind of removed and my face is a little bit red from the brow wax, but let's share our Nuuly picks for the month. Like I mentioned, we have this little shrug that I think is super cute. I always just get chilly when I'm going into the grocery store, hanging out at home, and so I like stuff like this. I also got this, oh my gosh, this is so thick. I got this cardigan because I'm freezing when I wake up in the morning. Aiden makes it so cold in our apartment at night, which is better for sleep. I know scientifically you sleep better when I think the temperature is around 65 degrees. You might have to fact check me on that, but it's so cold when I first wake up. And so I wanted just a big cardigan to throw on. And I also thought for our little getaway, this would be nice to have for just lounging in the cabin. But then I checked the weather and it says 92 degrees and raining the whole weekend. It's not ideal because I can take the heat, because especially near Austin, there are a bunch of places to go swim. We could take Cash, who swam a lot of places before around there. But what do you do when it's 90 degrees and raining? It's not even cozy inside. It's just hot and rainy, but it might not actually rain. It's been saying that it'll rain and it doesn't. So I got this little mini dress that I thought was super sweet. I love anything that has little puff sleeves. I think is super cute. This might be a little too short, but we will see. I think I got this in a small, which is usually my size, but this is kind of a different brand for me. So we'll see. I also got this dress that it's just a very me dress. Oh my goodness, this is fully see-through. This is entirely see-through. What did people wear under this? Oh, that totally stinks. I don't even know if I have a slip or anything, but I got this cute little pink plaid dress. And this had such wonderful reviews. I don't know if you can tell, but it doesn't look like it on camera, but you can totally see through it. So that's a bummer. I'm kind of feeling like this is not my favorite month of Nuuly picks. I got this pair of overalls. These are kind of longer overalls. These are from Levi's and they look like they're a little bit oversized. I feel like these are going to be so cute and oversized. Really, really excited about these. I love a good pair of overalls. And then lastly, I just got this comfy little pullover. I have wanted to rent this for a while, but I thought for going to the gym, it's just a comfy little pullover to throw on. I like the collar on it. I know it's getting hot here, but I just always get cold when I'm going out and about. And so I thought that this would be nice to have. Probably not my favorite month of picks. You know, it's kind of hit or miss. I usually have mostly hits. I think for the rest of the night, I have a little bit of work that I need to get done. Aiden and I think are just gonna grab dinner out tonight, go on a little date night, which I've been trying to do lately, but it's a game plan.
Good morning. It is Thursday morning. I'm getting ready right now because I actually have a Zoom call at 10 o'clock today with a brand. So just putting on a little bit of makeup for that. And then after this, like I mentioned, I'm meeting up with my friend Taylor. Really looking forward to it. We're going to this burger place that I picked specifically because it has a lot of like playground type equipment, and she's bringing her 1-year-old daughter too. So I thought that that would be kid friendly. I've never been there, but they also have salads and stuff, so that should be fun. And then after that, I want to do some prep for our little road trip this weekend. We've been to Wimberley quite a few times before, probably like 5 or 6 times. And so I'm already pretty familiar with like the restaurants and everything, but I do want to map out some hikes. And I also want to see if I can find some places that Cash might be able to swim at, because there are so many different water holes and swimming parks in that area. But a lot of times you can't bring dogs to all of them. And so I want to map out which ones do allow dogs, because Cash loves to swim. And so if it's going to be 90 degrees, I would really like to find some place where he can cool off, especially if we're going on hikes and stuff. because that is pretty hot for him. It might actually be too hot for him to go on hikes, but we could at least find some places just for him to swim a little bit. I also want to make a grocery list too of some kind of campfire foods. Like I mentioned, it is gonna rain, although it has said that it's gonna rain all this week and it has not rained at all. So hopefully that will happen for this weekend too, but I think I'm just gonna plan out some breakfast stuff and then we'll probably end up eating out for dinner. We will grab groceries on the way down there, so I'm gonna make a little list of everything. And yeah, that's it.
Hi.
Logged in a bit. I'm actually headed to the grocery store right now. I'm just grabbing some stuff to make some dinner. I'm trying to do a deconstructed stuffed pepper kind of casserole situation because I love stuffed peppers, but I never actually like eating the peppers when they're stuffed. I just feel like I eat all the stuff inside. So I'd rather just cut up the peppers and make a casserole. So I'm gonna try a new recipe I've never tried, but I need to grab a couple of things here. And I also need to grab Cash some dog food. So those are the errands. I also did meet up with Taylor earlier. I didn't end up recording too much with us getting lunch just because we were just there for like an hour or so. We were just catching up. It was so much fun to meet her. I always love meeting internet friends in real life. It's always just so surreal and it makes me really grateful for the internet. I know the internet can be wild and not necessarily the most positive place all the time, but I have met so many of my friends through Instagram. I'm just always so thankful for that time just to connect.
If you're ever on the fence about getting a golden retriever or honestly just any dog in general, this is my sign that you should go for it. It's been 2 years with Cash, and the amount of times I just think when I'm hanging out with this dog, he is the best money I've ever spent probably on anything in my life. I love this dog so much. He is just my dream dog because I can lay like this with him for an hour, 2 hours, and he will stay. He will stay the whole time. We take naps together. He is just the cuddliest dog in the whole world. And I know that's most golden retrievers, but he is just especially the biggest cuddle bug ever. Although he doesn't love the camera being in his face right now. But I just love this dog so much. He is truly my best friend. I remember being kind of nervous when we got him, like, this is a big responsibility, taking care of a dog, and it definitely is, but it is 100% so worth it. I just love him so much. He's my little best friend. He's not so little though. He's kind of sort of huge. I also get questions if we would ever get another dog, and I don't think so right now. I think down the road, like to think that Cash would like having another dog in the family, but I also think he really likes having all of the attention. Like, he plays well with other dogs, but he definitely does get jealous when, like, we're giving more attention on even other things other than him. And so yeah, I don't know. I don't know if we'd ever get another dog, probably down the road, but it is a lot of responsibility, especially finding people to watch two dogs versus one, I imagine is a lot trickier. So, and he definitely has a crazy side. Like, he gets hyper when people come over, and especially with Aiden, I feel like Aiden, he matches kind of the energy of the room. And so for me, this is a lot of times what my energy is like. I'm so excited to have a house too for him and have a backyard soon. He's gonna love it, and we're also gonna love it. We're not gonna have to take him down the elevator 5 to 6 times a day anymore. Of course, we're still gonna walk him and everything, but it'll be nice just to be able to let him outside in the backyard. But I'm gonna go ahead and start some dinner. It's about 6:45, getting hungry. Here's how it turned out. I will say that the recipe called for pork and beef, but I don't really like mixing meats, and so I just did all chicken. So it turned out good, pretty simple, but. It is Friday. I have had kind of a crazy Friday because we worked out this morning, walked Cash, and then I actually had to go pick up my car from the place that was fixing it. So my car's all fixed, which is good, but I wasn't expecting to do that today. So we kind of have a lot to do. I need to pack for our little getaway, and then I also need to finish editing a whole video, do a thumbnail, get everything uploaded, because I'm just not sure what the Wi-Fi situation is going to be like at the tiny cabin. But I wanted to show you guys what I'm packing in case you're interested in going to one of these tiny cabins. They're a ton of fun. I don't want to pack a lot because it is really tiny. These getaway cabins are not big. So I'm trying to be more minimal, which usually I am not a minimalist when I pack. So this is what we have. Also, my outfit for today, these are the overalls that I showed you guys earlier. And then I'm just wearing a bandana from Madewell, threw my hair into some braids, and I'll share what I'm packing. So like I mentioned, the weather situation is not really ideal. And so I don't really know what we're gonna do. We're actually stopping by HEB to grab groceries, and I'm hoping to also find ponchos in case it rains. But one of the days, I'm thinking of actually stopping by, there's like a flower farm that also has just a bunch of stuff. It's really cute. And so I wanted to pack one cute outfit. So I have a skirt here, and then I brought a few different tops along with some bandanas because I always like to wear these. And then for hiking, I just brought this bodysuit. This is from Amazon. Really like it. And I'm also gonna wear my hiking boots with this outfit just to save space. And I also think that they're cute. I think they'll be cute with this. Very crunchy granola. I think we're gonna go to a winery with some friends one of the nights, and so I just packed some shorts because it is basically 90 degrees and the humidity is like 70% today. It feels like an armpit outside. So I'm just anticipating sweating. Also, I self-tan, but I'm gonna rinse it off when I get there. So that's why I'm looking pretty tan right now. I also just packed some sandals, my Converse. And so, yeah, I think that's pretty much it. Just one set of pajamas too, but I think that's everything for clothes. And then for other stuff, I just packed all my toiletries in here, and I wanted to bring my Polaroid camera. I actually got this from Amazon probably a couple months ago, but I keep forgetting to bring it when we do stuff. And so I want to bring this to hopefully get some just cute little Polaroid shots. I'm trying to start doing that more. And then I'll show you the kind of kitchen stuff we're going to bring. I'm not bringing a ton of kitchen stuff. We are just going to be pretty minimal on food. For dinner, we are just going to eat out most nights, I think. It would be fun to do like a whole campfire situation, but I just don't know with the weather, so I don't want to bank on that. And there are also so many good restaurants out. So I stop and get some breakfast stuff, just quick stuff that we can have in the cabin with us. I'm also bringing my portable tripod. This is for my phone that also has like a little remote in case we want to take photos together. I always like to bring that. Aiden likes to have Celsius, so I'm bringing those. And then for coffee, I know that they do have a kettle that you can use. And so I'm just gonna bring my Chemex because that's easy. I am a little worried about this breaking in the car. I think it should be okay, but got that. Cash's dog food in here, and then just a giant thing of Goldfish because I love Goldfish. It's my favorite snack, and so I always like to bring that with us. I think that's everything that I'm packing. Like I said, I just didn't feel like I needed a ton of stuff. Again, it's supposed to be like camping, but we're just kind of using it as an Airbnb. We're not going to do the full experience because we've already done that once. I hope you guys enjoyed this vlog. I know it was a bit all over the place. I feel like most of the vlogs lately have been a little bit all over the place, but I'm really, really excited for this weekend. I think it'll be fun to just get outside if we can. And yeah, I always love our little road trip, so it should be a good time. But I'm so thankful for you guys. I hope you guys enjoyed, and I'll catch you guys in my next video. Bye, friends.